Hey guys, Musical.ly is here today and I'm back with another video. Now today's video we're going to be reacting to an Ice Nine Kills song called The Jig Is Up. This is obviously, you know, going to be about Jigsaw, so that's going to be the horror movie theme for this one. Unlike the other ones had a music video. This one seems to just be, you know, have the art cover and stuff. So it's not going to be like the other ones. I didn't assume this entire album to have a music video for every song. Obviously, it's not reasonable to have a music video for every song and album. I don't know if there's ever been a band that has had a music video for every song in an album. But yeah, they do have, majority of their songs do have music videos, so that's pretty cool. I think this one doesn't have any dialogue scenes either. I think it just jumps straight into the music and ends with the music. So that's going to be interesting, a little bit departure. Like I said, I just enjoy listening to the music and the journey and, you know, the story that's unveiling throughout this album. I think it's pretty cool. I also love the, you know, horror movie theme and all the horror movies they go going through. Obviously, the first few are going to be starting off with the most iconic and most well-known, and then there's going to diverge into more of the smaller ones. Not too small, because Jigsaw is still a big franchise, and even Jaws and stuff like that, but less synonymous when it comes to the slasher horror film genre compared to the other ones. So yeah, this is going to be pretty interesting. I can't wait to get into it, so yeah, let's get into it. Okay, so this song is more of it's more screamo slash, you know, metal. I'm not a very big metal guy. Yeah, I can listen to some metal bands and some metal songs, but usually the songs that I listen to aren't that heavily metal, like, oriented, like, the screams and growls aren't that prevalent in the song. I personally, it's just not my, cup of tea, so I can definitely see why some people might like this song or love the song, but for me personally right now, I'm just not really feeling it too much. Also, I do want to say this, I fixed the problem that I had with the whole echoing problem. I know some of my videos are having some weird double echoing thing, and that was because I had this software running for my gaming. I was trying to do some game recording, and the audio for that thing, it was messing it up, so I disconnected that. I disconnected it. I didn't know that it was going still, and it was messing with the recording sound. So I disconnected it. So this one and my future videos should not have any, you know, audio problems with echoing and stuff. But yeah, this song is more, you know, heavily scream-oriented, more like, you know, metal style, which personally I respect if you guys like that style of music, but personally for me, it's just not my, cup of tea. It's just not the, you know, style of music that I like listening to. So the screaming parts, I don't really care too much for. The chorus part, that was actually pretty good. I think it sounded very nice, but it was still hard to hear, obviously, because this is supposed to be a Jigsaw where he talks usually and communicates through a TV or a speaker and stuff. His, you know, his voice and his audio is kind of muffled, or, you know, the tone of it is changed. And that's what they implemented a little bit in here with the middle parts where there's talking into it. So I do love the element of that, but it also does kind of make it a little bit harder to understand what he's saying because of the sound getting filtered through a certain way. But I still think it's a very enjoyable and fun song. And if you guys love this, I can definitely see why. But for me personally, I just feel like this is one of the songs on this album that I'm not going to be too fond of. So yeah, let's get back into it. So that was The Jig Is Up by Ice Nine Kills from their album The Silver Scream. If I'm being honest, the first half I wasn't too big of a fan of, but the second half, after I, you know, unpaused it, I actually liked a lot more. The chorus went on a little bit longer, and then after that part, he had another clean vocal part, which I really liked. And like I said, my style and taste of music is a lot different than other people, and when I say I don't like that, I don't mean that it's bad. I just mean personally, I don't, you know, that's just not something I really connect with as much. I'm usually a guy who likes more cleaner vocals, and I listen to more regular rock music, you know, alternative rock, pop punk, there's a couple other ones, you know, Scene, all these other ones. I don't really dive that much into metal, and when I do, it's usually more songs that are less heavy. And it's not because I don't like heaviness, it's just the one they get it is usually screaming, and I feel like just having purely raw screaming or growling for me just doesn't do it. But I think towards the ending I start to like it a lot more. I love the part when I do love his singing. His singing voice is very beautiful, especially when he's saying the part about when he's saying part of the saying machine. I don't know why, but the way he sang machine just sounded really good to me. And the other part where he was like singing the other clean vocal that was in the chorus, I also really enjoyed. And here's the thing about me, I'm weird, and I know there's some people like this too, but when I listen to a song the first time, sometimes I can be very critical and I might not like it, but as the more I listen to it, I might end up even loving the song. That doesn't always happen, but it is the case a lot of the times. And if you guys hear me saying something critical about any song, not just on this album, where I'm like, I didn't like this or that, just know that that's not my opinion throughout my entire life. It's just that at that moment, or at least the first time I heard it, it just didn't connect with me. But at a couple more tries, I'll end up probably loving it. It's not a guarantee 100%, but it is, you know, that's just the case when it comes to me, is that it's not always going to be, you know, not what I say always in the video is what's going to feel like throughout the entire time. There's definitely been songs on this channel that I have reacted to, which I have, you know, criticized or possibly didn't like that much. And then now I listen to it live and I love it. So I could end up loving this, especially when I do the album, reviews, because I re-listen to all the songs from the album. And when I usually do that, I end up, even the songs I might not like as much, I end up loving more. So it really, you know, changes when you hear multiple times, definitely. Sometimes a song that I liked, I probably thought, it's actually not that great. Or a song that I hated, I could go from loving it to or even hating it more. So who knows? I might end up loving the song a lot more. So yeah, I just got to keep on getting through them, finish them up, and then, you know, just do, that's when I get my album review and, you know, listen to the songs over again, my opinion should be more akin to what I would normally feel about the song compared to, you know, the first time I listened to it. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed, and stay tuned for next time.